Dear colleagues, friends, at the outset, let me welcome the participants to the conference Aleppo, City Free of Terror, New Life, New Hopes. We have decided to convene this conference in order to tell the truth about the events which took place before and after Aleppo was set free from terrorists. Our purpose is to give the floor to people who brought peace to this city and who witnessed personally and who are witnessing now how life in Aleppo is changing. And our panelist has already introduced the participants to the conference, so I want to talk about them, and I will proceed to the main part of my statement. Ladies and gentlemen, we all understand and we all recall that when the Eastern Aleppo was being set free from al-Nusra and other radical groups, some world mass media, with the help of terrorist supporters, disseminated fake news online on the situation in the city, and a whole number of states and international organizations echoed and disseminated this fake news. I would like to set a couple of examples. When the operation of the Syrian army with the support of the Russian airspace Space Forces on the release of Eastern Aleppo from Jabhat al-Nusra, social media started disseminating a photo which showed a girl in a dirty dress running on a semi-broken,
on a street
with dead bodies over it. In reality, it was a photo taken on a movie set when a video clip of Lebanon singer Hibat Abadji was being shot. And another famous symbol of Aleppo's suffering is a wounded three-year-old boy Omrat Dankish, who was used by the Oscar-winning white casks, white helmets, in their immoral propaganda instead of providing help to him. And during today's conference, we'll go back to this issue. We'll show this boy and his father, who live in Aleppo in security, in peace, and who curse terrorists and their supporters. At the same time, some mass media, states, international organizations turned their blind eyes to terrorist atrocities, shooting at civilians who tried to flee from the city through humanitarian corridors built by Syrian and Russian military. Terrorists used booby traps disguised as children's toys. They used chlorine and other toxic substances in order to kill civilians. They shot on a regular basis out of mortar guns and reactive artillery at residential neighborhoods in eastern Aleppo. They deprived citizens of medicine, food, and water. They used the population as a human shield. So they are responsible for many severe crimes, and they are responsible for atrocity in Aleppo. The archpriest of Antioch Orthodox Church of Ilya Prophet said, jihadists destroyed Christian sanctuaries, 13 ancient churches
were destroyed.
Let's just have a look at the figures. Before Eastern Aleppo was seized by terrorists, 150,000 Christians had lived there. After that, only several dozens remained. And now 25,000 Christians from Aleppo came back home.
Unfortunately,
the misleading disinformation campaign, which started in autumn 2016 and was devoted to the alleged Aleppo's lacking food and medicine, But at the same time, facilities were full with medicine and food, but terrorists didn't want to distribute it among the population. Ladies and gentlemen, the Syrian government, with the help of the Russian Federation, applies a lot of efforts to stabilize the situation in Aleppo, and it includes, first of all, the operation aimed at clearing the city of mines, which was very expeditious, and let us open the humanitarian access to the city and to start the restoration of the infrastructure, which had been destroyed by terrorists. Water supplies were renewed, which had been suspended because of terrorists. The contribution of Russian military doctors was also important because they saved people's lives who tried to flee from terror. After the city had been released, they continue their heroic endeavor. The military police of the Russian Federation's military helps to normalize the situation in the region. Representatives of the Russian Reconciliation Center distribute humanitarian assistance in Aleppo every day. These efforts bear their fruits. The families who had fled from their homes, trying to escape from terror, are coming back home. The citizens of the city are helping to clear the debris on their cities and to restore buildings. There is a very good sign. Football games of the Syrian Championship, of the Syrian Cup, take place again in Aleppo. And the fans claim Aleppo has come back.
Unfortunately, some
Western mass media, some states, international organizations turned a blind eye on these facts, and we didn't expect anything else from them. But it's very important for the international community to realize. It is very important for the international community to realize that the citizens of Aleppo still need assistance. It is necessary to help the Syrian authorities who are trying to restore a normal life in the city, and not to try to impede this important work with unilateral, illegal, anti-human sanctions and
It
is high time to renounce from this approach, from this practice. We urge all the states, all international organizations and NGOs to join their efforts in providing assistance to Aleppo in order to allow the citizens of this long-suffering city to forget all this, their suffering, and to bring back security, peace, and well-being to the long-suffering Syrian territory. Thank you for your attention.